किताब।
गुड आफ्टरनून फ्रेंड्स, ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ प्रेस इंफॉर्मेशन ब्यूरो आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू दिस प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस ऑन बजट 2015-16। वी आर प्रिविलेज्ड एंड ऑनर्ड टू हैव विद अस द ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर ऑफ फाइनेंस कॉर्पोरेट अफेयर्स एंड इंफॉर्मेशन एंड ब्रॉडकास्टिंग श्री अरुण जेटली जी एंड मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट फॉर फाइनेंस श्री जयंत सिन्हा जी। आई एक्सटेंड अ वार्म वेलकम टू यू सर। We have on the dais Shri Rajiv Mahashi, Finance Secretary, Shri Shaktikanta Das, Revenue Secretary, Shri Ratan P. Vattal, Secretary Expenditure, Dr. Shri Ratan P. Vattal, Secretary Expenditure, Dr. Hasmukh Adhiya, Secretary Financial Services, Srimati Aradhana Jori, Secretary Disinvestment, Dr. Arvind Subramanian, Chief Economic Advisor. I extend a warm welcome to you all, sirs and madam. Friends, the Honorable FM will make his opening remarks. After that, we will take a few questions. Friends, the Minister has taken time out of his very busy schedule to be here. We should make the best use of his presence. I request you to please frame your questions in a short and precise manner and restrict the question to one per individual. May I also request you to kindly switch off your mobiles and to keep them on silent mode. Over to the Honorable Minister for his opening remarks.
Well, thank you very much for all being here. Let me at the very outset express my gratitude to all the secretaries, the chief economic advisor, and of course my colleague the minister of state Mr. Jayant Sinha, and also all the officials who worked with them in the last few months scrutinizing various suggestions which were coming and then finalizing all the budget proposals. It was a challenging task. I don't want to repeat what already has been said in the budget statement in the morning, but I can tell you that there's a particular set of circumstances both very favorable and very challenging at the same time that we were working under. The first challenge, of course, was that there is a redefined architecture of the fiscal relationship between the center and the states. And obviously, the resources, both in absolute terms and percentage terms, available to the center have gone down. We do not regret it. In fact, we are happy that this has happened. It was long overdue. The 14th Finance Commission needs to be complimented for that. Being a government that was committed to cooperative federalism, we have gladly accepted that recommendation. And therefore, a very large part of the central revenue, we calculate it is about 47%. And if you take the national revenue of the center and the states together, it's about 62% that goes to the states. Now, this will be money which will be spent on the ground. This also means that states are equal co-partners, and their level of responsibility in enhancing national growth also increases. I'm sure all states will take it in the right spirit and contribute in this task of nation building. So we were first constrained by the fact that the resource available to us had declined. I think the second situation was that the world was enthusiastically looking at us. And when I speak of the world, predominantly both domestic and international investors. And therefore, notwithstanding that constraint, we had to carry on the track on which this government has functioned in the last 9 months. And there are a large number of unfinished tasks that we have to fill up, and we had to walk on a road which we have laid down for ourselves. And that obviously meant working for higher growth rates within limits of fiscal prudence. And therefore, of course, we do anticipate that our growth rates will be reasonably better than what they were this year. We anticipate, as has been pointed out in the economic survey, between 8 and 8.5. We had a choice to make. And the choice was that if we stuck to the pre-established fiscal deficit target of 3.6, which is prior to the 14th Finance Commission, we'd really have to cut down a very large part of the public spending. Neither could we abandon fiscal prudence. So we found the right balance in wanting to reach the 3% target in 3 years instead of 2 years. And we stuck to that road. This will obviously give us, in each of the 3 years, a reasonable amount of flexibility and a resource at our disposal, which would predominantly go to public spending. The public spending on infrastructure, which is the first key highlight, we have increased, notwithstanding the squeezing of the fiscal space. We've added and decided to explore other avenues of infrastructure long-term spending in terms of tax-free bonds, in terms of a fund being created where center also contributes. Maybe the PSUs may also contribute to that. We'll find funds for that purpose, and the large body of investors also contributes, both from domestically and predominantly internationally. We then had to concentrate on manufacturing, correcting some of the inverted duty structures and areas where rebate could be given, which were job creating areas. Obviously, the task of the national resource going to the weaker sections and the more vulnerable sections was very important. So we maintained or enhanced the spending as far as those sectors were concerned. We also brought a paradigm shift in the thinking, to the extent that you need to introduce ideas of social security within the system. So both for the weaker sections, keeping the principles of equity in mind, we have come out with certain ideas. With regard to the eastern region, there was a special place in our policy. And as far as the taxpayers are concerned, we have prioritized what our ideas were. We want more money in the hands of the taxpayer. We wanted to incentivize them to save for their own future. And those savings in turn pushes up the domestic savings rate and are useful for the country as a whole. And those who evade the law, we had a tough message for them. Now, these are amongst the various highlights, and I'm sure this will balance growth, fiscal prudence, equity, as also create confidence in the minds of the investors. Under the circumstances when our space was to a large extent squeezed, there were certain structural reforms in terms of ideas, in terms of new legislations which we have proposed. These will be in addition to what's already pending in Parliament, and I'm quite sure that the next few sessions of parliament on economic legislations, we'll have our hands full. That's all I had to say. If there are any queries you have to me or to any of my colleagues.
Yeah. Okay, let's start with this gentleman here.
Roadmap. Now you're going to achieve 3% by 2017-18, justifying that you're going to increase the capital spending. But the big elephant in the room is the Reserve Bank of India. You think they're going to support this idea of yours and you know, support you in enhancing growth by cutting rates anytime soon now?
Well, I think you need to have a little patience. You'll get the answer to your question.
Yeah. This lady here, please.
Mr. Jeetley, Smita Sharma from TV Today Network. You know, given that increasingly there are more states which are ruled by the BJP, would that help you in plugging leakages when you talk of subsidies? You know, how do you, because you're continuing with social spendings, you're continuing with subsidies, how do you really look at plugging in those leakages? And secondly, the one rank, one pension was expected to be implemented. There was a sense that the Ministry of Defense had given to army personnel. There seemed to be no mention of this in your budget.
See, as far as leakages are concerned, it is not a party issue. I don't think there is any political party in India which stands up and says that leakages in subsidies must continue. Therefore, it's not an issue of a BJP government or a non-BJP government. At the moment, oil and diesel having been linked to the market, our next strategy in the subsidies is twofold. We are concentrating on LPG, where the cash transfer system is being implemented. We implement that in toto. And thereafter, I have in the budget today appealed to the more affluent ones to voluntarily relinquish the subsidies because they are not entitled to them. We'll await our success in that direction before we proceed further. And your next question was? Well, as far as I have already in the last budget said that we are going to implement the one rank, one pension. This need not be stated on every occasion. We are completely committed to it. The methodology of calculating that one rank, one pension is an issue pending between the services and the defense ministry. As and when that idea is formulated, not only it should be implemented, it will be implemented. And you may only notice that I have today, despite the squeeze, increased the allocation for defense by more than almost 25,000 crores.
Yeah,
sir,
Venkatraman.
Sir, my question pertaining to Tamil Nadu project, that's a Sethu project. Sethu Samudram project. The previous government allotted more than 4,000 crores for the implementation project. Where today's project is
one of your. Well, whatever proposal we get from the Ministry of Shipping, we'll consider that, and I am sure they would also speak to the state government in this regard.
Sir.
Yeah, please.
Sir Dheeraj from the Economic Times, you in your budget today mentioned about strategic sale in loss making PSUs. Now, will this be a sort of what happened in the previous NDA regime, and how do you intend to carry this? Because there has been no definitives on this.
Well, the Secretary of Disinvestment is here. I have said that so far we've been speaking in terms of disinvestment in some cases. We have an elaborate roadmap in front of us. As far as strategic sales are concerned, certainly we are not averse to the idea. Wherever we find the possibility existing, we will certainly consider it. I am not stating or defining any particular company at the moment.
मैं प्रशांत हूँ एबीपी न्यूज़ से. आपने अपने बजट स्पीच में स्वच्छ भारत सेस लगाने की बात कही है. अगर जरूरत पड़ी तो क्या कोई टाइम फ्रेम है आपके दिमाग में?
देखिए, कोई टाइम फ्रेम नहीं है. स्वच्छ भारत अभियान के लिए साधन बजट में से आ रहे हैं, साधन एलोकेट भी किए हैं, और इसलिए हमने एलोकेटेड अमाउंट डाल दिया है. इसके अलावा एक दूसरा संकेत भी बजट में दिया है कि जो सीएसआर स्पेंडिंग होगी उसमें हमने कोई टैक्स ऑप्स भी बजट में मेंशन किए हैं. उसके बाद अगर आवश्यकता हुई तो आज थियोरेटिकली हमने लिमिट बढ़ाई है, एक्चुअल सेस नहीं लगाया, इट्स ओनली एन एनेबलिंग प्रोविजन. नाउ इफ फंड्स आर रिक्वायर्ड वी यूज द एनेबलिंग प्रोविजन, इफ दे आर नॉट रिक्वायर्ड सो बी इट.
सर मैं शशांक उज्जैन टीवी से. सर पूर्व पीएम मनमोहन सिंह ने कहा है कि आम बजट 2015 के इरादे तो अच्छे हैं लेकिन इसको लेकर कोई रोडमैप नहीं है. आम बजट 2015 के इरादे अच्छे हैं लेकिन कोई रोडमैप नहीं है इसका.
धन्यवाद.
सर
So, the middle class is concerned about the service tax. Would you like to say something to them? Because now the general perception is that they will have to end up paying more on host of services.
Well, madam, if you consider, services is a large part of the Indian economy. In fact, today it's the largest segment of the Indian economy. Now, if services are not levied to tax, agriculture, in any case, there is no tax. So that only leave the entire taxation to manufacturing sector and render it uncompetitive. Therefore, the society runs on tax. Tax is an instrument of social engineering in a society. Therefore, services have to be taxed, otherwise you won't get any services as far as the government is concerned, because the government has no money.
Yeah, that gentleman there. Yeah.
Sir Arup from Business Standard. Sir, it was pitched as a Make in India budget, and you did speak a lot about improving India's manufacturing prowess. However, what was not there was any incentives for SEZs, including perhaps a reduction in MAT. So could you throw some light upon that, sir?
Well, what is there, and what's not there is not there. Because a budget has to balance its figures also.
Yeah, that lady there, please. Yeah.
Arunji, I'm Sheila Bhatt from Rediff.com. I wanted to ask you that this budget was weighted entire, not just in India but many other countries, thinking that this is a Modi. This budget will make take Modi Sarkar to the next level. So thinking that budget will have a really a big bang, great ideas for future and nation building. Why do you think there are there any such ideas? Can you
well normally. You ask questions, I don't, but I'll ask you. Give me one big idea which is not there.
I'm asking you, sir. Today is
your No, that means if you have no idea, it's a question just being asked for the sake of it. Many people have told me.
You think that this government will many go people to the next have, many, because of this budget?
Many people have told me that you must have a big bang idea, and I've asked them to suggest one. So far, their response has been what your response is.
Yeah, Sisir. Sisir.
Sir, Shishir from Hindu Business Line. My question is about, there is a lot of focus on JAM, that's Jan Dhan, Aadhaar and mobile. What is going to happen about PDS, food, fertilizer and kerosene? Are you going to implement direct benefit for these three items?
Well, I think, let me not overreact by answering that question now. Our general approach to subsidies has been stated. Subsidies will remain there, but leakages will not remain, and subsidies are going to be rationalized. If you dissect that paragraph, these are three things you come out of it. Therefore, instead of overstating what is going to happen on a subsequent stage, I have clarified at this stage we are working on LPG. We are also trying to make sure that as many of the non-deserving entities in that category go out. When it is to be taken to another level, we'll let you know.
Yeah, please.
अरुण जी, आपने वीकर सेक्शन को और इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर पे पब्लिक स्पेंडिंग बढ़ाकर बहुत दोनों को बैलेंस करने की कोशिश की है, लेकिन इस चक्कर में आप मिडिल क्लास को भूल गए हैं. उस मिडिल क्लास में खासा वोट दिया था आपको.
मुझे लगता है कि उन दोनों का कहना है कि कुछ आपने ज्यादा ही मिडिल क्लास के लिए किया है. अब ये सारा जो पूरा समाज में अगर विकास आता है तो उसका स्वाभाविक लाभ हर वर्ग को होगा. मिडिल क्लास भी उसमें से एक है. और जो पूरा अगर आप चार्ट देख लें तो पिछले साल और इस साल मिलाकर जितने मिडिल क्लास टैक्स पेयर्स को रिलीफ जितना मिला है, मुझे नहीं लगता कि पिछले 68 बजट्स में बैक टू बैक दो बजट्स ने कभी इतना दिया होगा।
प्लीज दैट जेंटलमैन
सर। सौरभ इंडिया टीवी से। सर मिडिल क्लास को एक्सपेक्टेशन थी कि जिस हिसाब से आपने इनकम टैक्स स्लैब में पिछली बार थोड़ी सी रियायत दी थी, इस बार भी होम लोन पे या डायरेक्ट टैक्स पे कुछ ना कुछ।
देखिए माय अप्रोच हैज बीन, मेरी अप्रोच ये रही है कि मिडिल क्लास की सेविंग्स को इनकरेज किया जाए, उनकी जेब में ज्यादा पैसा जाया जाए, और जिस रोडमैप पे हम चले हैं वो मिडिल क्लास के लिए भी बेहतर है, उनके भविष्य के लिए भी बेहतर है, और ये सेविंग्स पूरी इन्वेस्टमेंट में कन्वर्ट होती है तो देश के लिए भी बेहतर है।
अरुण जी, रवीश तिवारी फ्रॉम इंडिया टुडे। यू सेट अ टारगेट ऑफ 8.5 लाख करोड़ फॉर फार्म क्रेडिट। देयर इज नो डेडिकेटेड बैंक फॉर फार्मर्स, इट्स द सेम कमर्शियल फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशंस दैट एक्सटेंड दैट क्रेडिट। आई एम वॉन्डरिंग व्हाई वाज अ नीड फॉर अ डेडिकेटेड बैंकिंग इंस्टीट्यूशन फॉर ट्रेडर्स। इज इट बीजेपी'स अपीजमेंट ऑफ इट्स ओन वोट बैंक?
दिस इज there have already been farm credit approaches from the banking system for farmers which have been going on. We've expanded the scope of those loans. There is a subvention also in that loans which takes place. As far as this segment of the very small traders are concerned, 5.77 crores in the country, these were completely unfunded categories. And therefore, it is for the first time that somebody has really thought of them, and that's why I have subtitled it Funding the Unfunded. And that's the approach we've followed with regard to them. You need not create a separate bank for them. We've created a separate fund for them, which will be leveraging the resources to these sections.
Yeah, that lady there, please. Yeah.
Now, PSUs, are you referring to loss-making PSUs?
Well, I am not confining myself to anyone in particular at the moment.
Yeah, Sinjoy.
Yes. Sir, you hinted at income tax cuts for the middle class in the near future. Is that likely in this financial year, or are you looking at the next 3 years for that?
Well, normally fiscal policies are in the budget itself.
Sapna.
Yeah. Sir. So what's the road forward on GST now? Some steps the budget has announced also.
Well, the first move will have to be that the empowered committee will have to decide on its chairman, because the previous chairman is no longer the minister, and he'd done a very good job. I thank him for that. And thereafter, we'll certainly be having a meeting with the empowered committee and trying to pass the constitution amendment in this session of parliament itself. And thereafter, the next round of legislations will have to be drafted in consultation with the empowered committee.
Sir, just one more question, sir, on direct taxes also. You mentioned that...
One question, let your...
couple of seconds, sir. You also indicated on direct taxes that you're trying to kind of streamline direct tax provisions in line with also your indirect tax proposal like GST. Could you throw some light on that? Because it was an important but a passing reference in your budget speech.
No, this reference was to a future roadmap that I have laid down. And a future roadmap that I have laid down is, and this is not for individual assessees. Individual assessees will continue to enjoy the exemptions because these are exemptions which incentivize savings. And I want to incentivize savings as far as individual assessees are concerned. This was in reference to the rate and of the corporate taxation in India. Now, as I mentioned, we are losing out on both counts. Most Asian economies have a far lower rate. I was told that the ASEAN rate is now 21.9% approximately, which is far lesser than ours. But we are losing on both counts. We are perceived as a high tax economy to investors. But because of various forms of exemptions, our actual realization is very low, 23%. And therefore, and this was something which was in the original code also, that can we move towards an area where we gradually bring down the rate to 25 and gradually phase out those of the exemptions which can be phased out. I didn't do it this year because I didn't want to take the whole industry by surprise. So it's better that it's put in, it's informed, and then over the next few years we can work it out.
Ritu Parnum from this side, from CNBC. Congratulations on your first full year budget, sir.
Sir, you have explained the rationale for ending exemption Raj. You have explained why you are also, you know, increasing your fiscal deficit target from 3.6 to 3.9 now. So can you give us a sense of how you will you take off, take forward your plans on ending exemptions, and will the won't the, you know, increase in fiscal deficit target, won't that squeeze the space for monetary easing, sir?
Be careful with your terminology, please, if you don't mind, because we've actually cut the deficit from 4.1 to 3.9. So deficit target has, the deficit has been reduced. It's not been exceeded. So it's relative to a notional target that it's higher than it should have been. But there's been an actual fiscal consolidation in 2015-16 relative to 2014-15. Just a matter of terminology.
Yeah.
You see, by spending less on infrastructure this year, at least the additional part, I could have met 3.6, but that was harmful to growth, so I didn't do it. Now, as far as this phasing out is concerned, you'll hear from us in the course of the year.
Yeah. Mr. Jaitley, a clarification on your reply to the earlier question on disinvestment when someone asked whether it will be loss-making. You said you're not specifying that. Is that a change from your earlier this thing? Because remember your first press conference, you had said that on disinvestment, the policy is more or less on the lines of that of the previous government, which is no strategic sale of profit-making PSUs.
Well, they never ruled out strategic sales.
Of profit-making.
They never ruled out strategic sales, though they never did it.
Mm-hmm.
They never did it, whether it was loss or profit.
Are you going to do profit-making ones also?
Well, I am not specifying any company at the moment.
Yeah. Sir. Sir, the money provided for bank recapitalization, is it enough considering the requirements that were
talked
about?
Well, the banks have been allowed last year, if you remember, to bring down government equity to 52% also, because that's the other source of revenue that they will have.
But are you looking at bank consolidation? Yeah.
Sir, one question on monetary policy framework.
Please ask your question. Yeah.
Sir, in the budget speech, you mentioned that you will introduce a bill to amend the RBI Act. When can we expect that bill, and can you share with us the details of proposed new monetary policy committee?
The monetary policy committee will be revealed in the bill, which, as FM said, would come sooner rather than later. In terms of months, there is no time frame, I'm sorry.
Yeah, we, FM will take last two questions. Yeah, that gentleman there. Yeah.
Arunji, I have a question here.
Samanya se samanya Ranvi ko naye umang aur utsah ke saath nayi cheezon karne ke liye prerit karne wala budget dene ke liye bahut bahut badhai deta hu aur main deshvasi mujhe vishwas hai ye budget aane wale dinon mein hame aur nayi unchaiyon par le jane ka ek avsar pradan karega.
Depreciation, an additional depreciation over and above what they normally are entitled to.
Okay.
And the reason why these two states have been selected, because you see, the eastern part of the country we've been saying we are going to concentrate on, because that has to be pushed up. There are two other states which have the benefit of a large quantity of coal, so they are going to be benefited in the normal course also.
Sir, yeah. Shahid Abbas from Cogence is here. Sir, you promised to overhaul government finances and cut corporate taxes in phases, remove business bottlenecks. But your budget does not reveal any sweeping economic overhaul measures, nor unveils any big bang reforms. And also, the statement of tax foregone is also missing this time, which is very...
Okay. Well, the statement of, I have always believed that what was euphemistically referred to as tax foregone was actually tax incentives for growth. Therefore, that booklet has been named accordingly.
Just the last question, please.
Siddharth from Bloomberg News. Sir, you have talked about in your budget about three important legislations: Indian Financial Code, then you're talking about Public Debt Management Office, and the third one is on the Monetary Policy Agreement. So these are all three, on these three issues, I believe the Reserve Bank of India has very strong views, and they till date continue to oppose, or they have very strong views on. So are you not entering into an era of confrontation with the Reserve Bank of India?
Well, the Monetary Policy Framework Agreement has been signed by the governor RBI. So I don't see why you say they are opposed to a monetary policy. They are not. And public debt management office idea actually emanates from RBI. It doesn't emanate from the government. It's a 1999 annual report of RBI. So RBI may have had some second thoughts, but that's a different story altogether. So I don't think they're opposed to a public debt management office. And this decision hasn't been sort of taken in isolation without talking to the RBI.
Thank you, Minister Sir. Friends, please join us on the fourth floor for tea. Thank you. Thanks for participating in this press conference.